Hi there, Jamie here at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. I recently made a video about three different ways on how to protect your Excel data. And one of the ways I showed you was protecting your worksheet with a password. And I also mentioned that you can hack that password in case you forget it so you can access that data again. So what I mean is when it's locked and if you try to change the number, you're gonna get this pop-up here that tells you there's a password. And if you click on Unprotect Sheet, there's the password. And if you don't know it or have forgotten it, I want to show you how you can hack it today on Teachers Tech. So I just want to point out on this workbook, I have two different sheets. I have no graphs here. You can see in sales order. This is the one that's password protected. If I go to change it, I get the I get this and I want to break that so I can open it without knowing the password. So what I'm going to do is make sure you have this saved up. I already have this saved in this folder right here. So I'm going to go ahead and close this and open up this folder. And the first thing I want to do is just show the extension name. And I'm on Windows 11. So I'm just going to go to View, Show, and go to File Name Extensions. And now I can see the .xlsx. Next is to create a copy of this, because if you do corrupt this as we make the changes, you still have your original. So I'm just going to right click and you can see the different options. You can go Control C, Control V, which I'm going to do right now to copy, and then to paste Control V. At this point, I need to change the file extension. So this .xlsx needs to be changed to .zip or zip. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to just go to rename or F2 on this. And I'm just going to change this just like this. So I'm going to click off of it and it's going to warn me that asking if I want to change this. I'm going to say yes. So now it is changed. So I just want to point out you do need a zip program on this to do the following steps. So I'm using WinRAR here, but whatever one you're using, you can follow along with that one. What I need to do now is double click on this file to open it up. And so it will open it up with what zip program you have as default. I have the WinRAR one. And I need to go, you can see the contents of this file. I need to go to this Excel folder and open it up. Then I need to go to worksheets right here. I have sheet one and sheet two. Remember I showed you that at the very beginning that I had two different sheets and one was password protected and one wasn't. Sheet two is the one with password protection. What I need to do at this point is actually, I'm gonna drag it over to this file to work in. You could drag it to your desktop if you want, but I'm just gonna take this sheet two and drag it over into the same place. I'm gonna open it up and look for something in here. So I'm gonna just double click on it. In my case, I'm gonna open this up with Notepad to do the editing on this. So I'm gonna select Notepad, hit okay. Don't be overwhelmed with what you're seeing here, because we're just gonna use a find command to search what we're looking for. And so if you use Control, hold down Control and then hit F, you're gonna find this right here. So we need to type the word protection in. So when you typed it in, just hit find next and you can see it finds it right here. This tells me that there's a password in this file, in this worksheet. If it didn't have this word protection, then it wouldn't have this. So we would be on the wrong sheet. We know this one wouldn't be password protected. What we need to do is delete something from this file. So where this word protection is, we need to go to the start of this angled bracket here and I need to highlight to the end where I see it close. So you can kind of go slowly through this and right here is where it closes. So this is the end where the bracket closes. I'm going to hit delete on this just like that and I'm going to save the file again. So just file and save and I can close this down. So what I need to do at this point, so I have my WinRAR program still open. I could delete this or over, I could bring it in and copy over, but just to be safe, I'm just gonna delete this file here. And I'm gonna drag sheet two back into it just like this. I'm gonna hit okay. And I have my new one inside here that I've deleted that password, that protection line of code from there. So at this point, what I need to do, I'm just gonna go back to over here And I'm going to change this back to the extension that I had before, that XLSX. So I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to go rename, get rid of the zip at the end and put in XLSX, just like that. And I want to make sure that I'm okay with this, hit yes. Let's go and open this one now. This, remember, this isn't the original one. This is just a copy of it. If I open this one up, I'm going to go to this. Let's see if I can, I'm on sheet two. I'm going to see if I can change the number now. And I put a random number and it let me. So if I go back to the original sheet though, and open this one up, and if I try to change something here, it's not letting me. The past, it's still protected inside of this. So if you ever get into a jam where you've forgotten your password, or maybe someone password protected a sheet and you gotta make sure you gotta make those changes to it, try this trick in order to be able to get access to that again. So I hope you like this Microsoft Excel tip on how to unlock those sheets that with those forgotten passwords. Let me know what you think and what else you're looking to learn. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.